Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Here comes a new challenger. Well, or an old challenger. Because I have a character roster of Tekken 7 in front of me. And I thought about, why not just also doing my predictions? We have a couple of characters already confirmed, right? But there are still a lot of characters that are going to be speculated whether they even return or not. So let me tell you my predictions here. So first, I have Akuma. Akuma. I don't think Akuma will return. Sorry for all you Akuma mains. It's I just think that Akuma was a one of a time like corporation. We had Street Fighter Cross Tekken, and back then we had rumors about doing the same with Tekken Cross Street Fighter. That never happened, so I guess the most close thing we got was Akuma being in Tekken 7. So that's why I think he's not going to return. Alyssa, I think she's going to be back because she is, she's Lars's waifu, yeah. I'm not that much of a fan, so I don't really care, but I think there is a good chance that we're going to see her again. So next is Anna. We have Nina confirmed, so there's also a good chance that Anna is going to be there. Can't imagine that they will just ditch her. Next on the list is Armor King. Armor King is, I think that's like a 50-50 situation. It is because, I don't know, every time I see King and Armor King, I think a little bit about these Echo characters from Smash Brothers. You know what I'm talking about? Like Peach and Daisy, for example. Now, one could argue that Armor King has way more like individual animations and moves to be a totally different character, and that is totally true. I just think when a fighting game gets too many characters that are too similar in style, like you have one wrestler, one ninja type of character, one samurai type of character, one assassination type of character, then you have the schoolgirl type of character, then the karate type of character, then you have the big boy. Armor King from a design is basically the same as King, just a little bit different. I don't want to say he's the same, but I don't want to say he's different either, you know? It's a little bit weird. So I think there is a good chance for Armor King to return because Armor King has a big fan base. A lot of people like Armor King as much as they like King. So I think there's a good chance we see him again. But it's not guaranteed, I think. Because we also saw King having animations and stuff from Armor King. But that already happened in the past as well. So it's totally 50-50 when it comes to Armor King. Asuka, she's already confirmed. Bob. Well, Bob is the big guy, right? I think he, since he's the only, not just big, he's not like Fakum Ram big, but he's more like an overweight kind of character. But at the same time, he's like the speedy type of guy. So he's like Rufus from Street Fighter 6, right? So I think Street Fighter 4. Fucking hell. Is Rufus even in Street Fighter 6? Nobody knows that. So I think Bob is unique enough to be back. There's a place for him in the game. I just don't know how much people actually really like to play him. I was never really interested in that character. Brian Fury, Brian is, he's part of the Tekken series for so long now. He has legacy, so yeah, I think he's going to be back. There's a good chance for him to come in back. Claudio, I'm indifferent about Claudio. I don't care about Claudio, right? So if Claudio is going to return, I don't know, maybe some people like him, some people not. I don't really care, so I cannot even form any opinion about that. So now Devil Jin, I think Devil Jin is a little bit obsolete. If they fuse Jin and Devil Jin in one Jin, we don't need a Devil Jin anymore, right? And I would actually prefer that, because I don't like these bloated character lists in fighting games, when basically there's just another form of a character. I think it became totally crazy when you look at games like Budokai or something, like these old Dragon Ball games where you have, even in Dragon Ball FighterZ, like how many Gokus do you have? You have Super Saiyan Goku, Super Saiyan Blue, you have Kid Goku, you have Base Goku, Ultra Instinct. So there's already five Gokus. It's a little bit crazy if you ask me. I mean, in Dragon Ball FighterZ, it makes more sense for the characters to be separated, but I think in Tekken, I think they should fuse the characters. So I don't need Devil Jin. And I also think this is going to happen, because if you also want to add new characters to the game, they need to make some room, right? And Devil Jin would be a good opportunity to create that space. Dragunov, I would like to see him return. I think Dragunov is a cool character, especially because of the Metal Gear memes. So I hope he's going to be back. And I think he has a good chance to be back as well, because he's well received. A lot of people like him. Eddie. So Eddie Gordo. They already ditched him for Christy, was it, in Tekken 4, right? So that's actually a pretty much of a proof that even the most famous characters in any fighting game, they can also get replaced for a game, right? So Eddie is one of the most famous Tekken characters, because so many people remember him from Tekken 3. We were kids playing PlayStation 1, and everyone was like playing Eddie, because Eddie was so flashy, right? So I think Eddie has so much legacy that we're going to see him again. But they could also bring back Christy for, I don't know, just for another game, right? I would not like to see both return, to be honest, because that would just be echo characters, right? Eliza, vampire, sleepy vampire lady. I don't know, man. She was an original design. She's a new character for Tekken 7, so there is a good chance that they bring back Eliza. But I cannot say. I don't have that much to do with this character. I would leave it as a 50-50. Fakumram, I'm also indifferent about Fakumram. I'm not interested in that character, but he is like he's the Sagat of the series now, basically, right? The Thai, Muay Thai guy. Usually the Thai people I know, they're pretty small, but he's massive, right? So I think he has also, with his glowing body and with his tattoos and design, I think he's unique enough to make a return. The question is, does he have a fan base that actually is big enough to want to see him return, right? If there's not much interest in the character in general in the player base, then we will probably not see him. Feng, I think it's pretty much guaranteed that Feng will return, because Feng is a very, he's not just a cool character, he's also well received in the community. He has lots of people like to play Feng. So I think that's pretty much guaranteed that Feng is going to be back. Ganryu, Well, Ganryu is, if I'm comparing again to Street Fighter, I think Ganryu is like the Honda of the series, but the difference between Honda and him is that Honda is famous and popular. I think Ganryu, nobody's interested in Ganryu, so there is a good chance that Ganryu is going to be gone. We will see, but I don't see many chances for Ganryu to return, to be honest. Geese Howard, well, he was also one of these special DLC characters, special corporation characters. Like Akuma, who was from Street Fighter, Geese Howard was from King of Fighters, right? SNK. So I think... Ah, that's difficult. Let me see. Geese Howard. No. I don't know, man. I think DLC characters, they were just one of a time, you know? It was... I don't see Geese return. Gigas. Probably dead. We don't need another Jack, right? We have Jack, and Gigas is basically just another Jack type of character. And how many players out there play Gigas? Two, three, four? I've seen the Gigas once. I don't know. Also super uninteresting. I don't know, man. I don't think he's going to be back. And we also saw Jack having Gigas moves, I think, right? So that's also another indicator that he's not going to make it. Heihachi Mishima. Now here comes the icon. He is basically the character of Tekken. A lot of people say Heihachi is dead. Come on, man. I mean, you can't take death serious in Tekken anyways. So people dying or people surviving in Tekken, the most ridiculous situations, yeah? So it's already a meme. It's already kind of a meme. That Heihachi and Kazuya, they always survive anything. But if he's truly dead, I think he's still going to return. I think there's a very good chance that we're going to get Heihachi as like the first DLC character or something like that. So by that way, they can focus on the story. The story shifts more into the direction of Jin and Kazuya, right? Because now Heihachi is dead in the story, but he's going to return as a playable character in multiplayer, like Kazumi, for example, in Tekken 7, right? Because I cannot imagine a Tekken game without Heihachi. He has the most legacy of all Tekken characters. And people say, yeah, but Kazuya was also missing in Tekken 3. Yeah, that was Tekken 3. That had only two games before. But we have so many Tekken games now. Such a massive legacy. Decades, yeah? That Heihachi is never gonna miss. If he's not in the base game as a multiplayer character, I think it's pretty sure that we're going to get him as DLC. Also, a lot of people out there main Heihachi, right? So, yeah, that's my opinion on Heihachi. Huarang is also legacy and like the best friend and also kind of rival to Jin. So, I'm pretty sure that we're going to see Huarang. And of course, he has to be back because as a friend of mine, greetings to remember this. R3, you are going to get a chance to beat me again with Huarang, okay, in Tekken 8. But this time then you're going to have to really like you have to give it your best because I'm not going to make it easy for you. So yeah, pretty much sure that Hoang is going to be there. Jack is already confirmed. Jin is already confirmed. Josie, I'm telling you, I don't care for Josie. I'm so indifferent about Josie. I don't give a damn. She's just another girly girl that, yeah, she has nothing special about her, I think. So maybe there's also a fan base that likes Josie. I don't know. I just don't care. So that's why I also can't say anything about her return or not. I just don't care. Julia, she has massive legacy. So yeah, I think... And she's also considered one of the best characters in the pro scene. So yeah, I'm 100% sure that we are going to see Julia. Katarina. I think with Katarina, it's like a 50-50 situation. Katarina has actually a lot of Christie vibes, if you ask me. Kind of looks the same. Katarina was also new to Tekken 7 and her story was tied to Gigas. But I can see her return maybe then without Gigas. I think Katarina should get the chance to return. I like the character. Not the design maybe, but the moves and stuff. She's a great character for people who like to learn the game. So I'm not hyped for her return, but I would accept it if they bring her back. I think she's a good addition to the roster. Kazumi. I think Kazumi. I don't care if she would return, but I also don't need her, and I think she's not going to come back. We have June, right? We have now June and Jin, and no Heihachi and Kazumi anymore. So. And Kazumi and Kazuya. Fucking hell, man, these names. So, yeah, we had Kazuya and Kazumi. Mother and son in Tekken 7. Since we now get Jin and June, I don't think we're going to see Kazumi. I don't think so. Kazuya already confirmed, of course. King already confirmed. Kuma. Not Akuma. Kuma. Just the bear. Kuma. Kuma... and Panda, they have both also legacy, but at the same time you could say well, if you like goofy animals, why not bring Gon back, the little dinosaur? And there was also fucking Kangaroo. Yeah, I don't need silly animals in Tekken. I don't need them, but I also don't care if they are added. So if Kuma and Panda return, I guess it's fine. I just can't make a prediction here. Kunimitsu. I think Kunimitsu is a cool character. I like the ninja thief kind of character, so I would like to see her return. And I think there's an 80% chance that she's going to be back, because she is well received as well. A lot of good attacks. There is still a fan base, so it's not 100% sure, but I think there's a good chance we're going to see her. Lars is already confirmed. Law is already confirmed. Lee, well, Lee is also, to me, like an 80% chance. He has a lot of legacy, so I think he's going to be back, but it's not 100% sure. Lei, I think Lei is Lei has to be there because he is very unique in fighting style and animation wise, but it's also not 100%. To me, it's also not like a 50%. To me, it's like an 80% as well. There's a good chance for Lei to get back, but He could also be ignored to make space for other characters. But I would like to see Lei as well again. Yeah. Leo, I don't care about Leo. Leroy is already confirmed. I don't know. Leo. let me still, I don't care about Leo, but let me still get, let me still make a prediction. 50-50. Leroy is already confirmed. Lydia, I think Lydia is going to be back. I mean, Harada even visited Poland and all that stuff. Why do all that? Why go through so much effort to create a new character for the game and then just ditch the character again, right? I think we see Lydia again. And I would say I would like to see her return. Lily, I think Lily is going to be back as well. She was important to the roster. I think she's going to be back. Lucky Chloe, fuck my life. Lucky Chloe is the character that I really would never miss. So yeah, just. If you ask me, if they would ask me like who is the number one character you want to see removed, it's Lucky Chloe. I just don't like that character. But will the character return? I don't know, man. If there's so many people not liking her, a lot of people tell me that they don't like Lucky Chloe. So maybe we don't get her. You will see. Marduk. Well, Marduk is like the rival of King, so I think the game needs Marduk. There's a good chance for Marduk to return, okay? And I would like to see him return, just because of interactions and stuff. Master Raven. What they could do is maybe they go back to the original Raven. Yeah, we had Raven, then we had Master Raven, now they go back to OG Raven. Same with Eddie and Christy, right? Like a swap in between a little bit. So I think we're going to see a Raven in the next game. It could be Master Raven, but it could also be original Raven, but I think we're going to see Raven. Miguel is such a, to me, Miguel is a boring character. He was on the revenge trip against Jin and all that. I think he's boring. So I wouldn't miss him. And I think there's also a good chance that he's actually not in the game. Then we have Negan, DLC character. Probably a one-at-a-time thing. We will not see him anymore. Nina, confirmed. Noctis, same with Negan. Noctis was a DLC. So we will probably not see him anymore. But let me say there's like a 10 to 20% chance they might give him another chance, just because a lot of people I know actually main Noctis. Panda, same with Kuma, already talked about that. Paul, already confirmed. Shaheen, I don't care really about Shaheen. So yeah, that's like a 50-50. Could return, could not, we will see. Steve has legacy, so to me, I think Steve is going to be back 100%. Ling Xia Yoshi's already got confirmed. Yoshimitsu, same legacy as Heihachi, like on that freaking level. Heihachi, Yoshimitsu has such a massive legacy. To Tekken, I cannot imagine they will not include him. They will probably give him a new design. It's always there. Yoshimitsu is always there with a new design. And I can't wait to see him getting revealed. Like half of the world probably. And last character on the list is Zafina. Zafina is I think Zafina has a good chance for return. She has enough people to like her, to care for her. I don't really care for her that much, but I can see her return actually, but not 100%. So that is my prediction. Let me say there are two characters that I would love to see as DLC or like guest characters. I would love to see Kiryu from the Yakuza series. I think that character would fit so well in a Tekken game. And the other character I would love to see is Kenshiro from Fist of the North Star. I would like to see Kiryu, but I would love to see Kenshiro. Fucking hell, what greatness could you achieve with a character like Kenshiro? The animations, all that, it could be hilarious. So yeah, those are my predictions for the Tekken 8 reveals. Obviously, the Tekken 8 reveals, we got flooded with trailers lately. Now it's a little bit of a break again, so we will see when we get the next trailers. We can't say for sure now, but this video could also be in a week or in a month totally outdated. But I think that's nice. That's good. You can watch it. You can see my predictions, and then you can compare these predictions to the reality. And I think that's interesting. So yeah, if there's anything else you think I should add, like what you think about characters returning or not returning, you can always contact me on Discord, on Twitter, or tell me in the comments, you know. So I'm looking forward to the release of Tekken 8 as hyped as before. Even more hype. The more trailers that are coming out, the more hyped I get. So yeah, can't wait for release date. I still think it's going to be 2024 because of Tekken World Tour, but who knows? I will not be the one who will say no to a nice surprise. So the earlier the better. So much about that. Those are my thoughts, and I wish you guys a great rest of the week, and see you next time. Auf Wiedersehen.